Salut, c'est Géraldine de Comme une Française. Today, I wanted to share books about feminism and awesome women because on 8th of March, le 8 mars, c'est la journée de la femme. Well, it's la journée internationale du droit des femmes. So I wanted to promote a bit of feminism and awesome things done by awesome women with awesome books written by women. Let's dive in. The first book I wanted to talk about today, because it's for boys and girls alike, it's Les Carnets de Cerises. Les Carnets de Cerises. So it's the Notebooks of Cerises. It's a wonderful BD, bande dessinée in French for boys and girls of all ages. It's written by Joris Chamblin and illustrated by Aurélie Néret. It's a wonderful book. I think I was the last one in France to discover those. So there are already five tomes, as we say in French. This is number one. It's called Le Zoo Pétrifié. I already talked about it in the Christmas episode because it's a wonderful gift for children and grown-ups because I loved it. So the little girl called Cerise goes on adventures with her friends. It's a really great book. I don't want to tell you anything about it because it will uncover the plot. Buy it. It's wonderful. It's around, I think, maybe 15 euros or something. It's a wonderful book. Les Carnets de Cerises. The second book is Les Culottés, tome 1 et 2 by Penelope Bagieux. It's a super famous bande dessinée in France at the moment. It's just been translated in English and many, many, many other languages. Penelope Bagieux published the lives of several women in bande dessinée over a few months in Le Monde, and then she published the book, and I read all of them online, and then I bought both books and I've given it several times. So you have tome 1 et 2, and I picked the one about French people, not because French people are better, no, it's because if you want to go and research more about them, you will find lots of resources in French. So here you have Clémentine and Joséphine. So Clémentine, it's Clémentine Delay, and she was une femme. Oops, she was une femme à barbe, and she had a bar in France, and she's French, and she was really awesome. And we have Joséphine Baker, who obviously is American, but then moved to France and was highly loved in France, and she even have la Légion d'honneur. And I think she has another one, because she was une résistante, as we say in French. I think it might be la Croix de Guerre. Well, a big, big thing. You know, it says here she got all the possible honors you can get in France because of her job during la résistance. So all of them are awesome. And if you want to go deeper into French culture itself, you will find other resources in French about two of those. You will probably recognize a few. And then on the tome 2, also two women with lots of resources in French. Thérèse Claire, who founded Les Baba Yaga, who is une maison de retraite for awesome women. And Katia Kraft, who was from Alsace. And she was une volcanologue and awesome as well. So on those two, you'll find lots of resources in French. If you want to give those books to younger girls, this one is great. This one has one which is very violent. So just maybe wait a little bit or skip this one if you're talking to a very young girl, because, or a boy, obviously, because one of them is really hard. So both are awesome, no matter what age or gender you are. They're really great. I highly, highly recommend both of them. Les Culottés. The third one is more about biology and sociology as well. It's Le Grand Mystère des Règles. So it's pretty easy to understand the topic. It's about period. In French, we say les règles for period. And it's by Jack Parker, who is a French woman. It's un pseudonym. So it's obviously a name of a man for a woman. And I love what she does online. So when I knew I was going to do this episode, I bought this book at last and I read it. Well, I read all of them. And it's great for teenagers, I would say, the whole book, because the first part is more about biology and what's... So you have yeah, everything, lots of things about the period itself. So it's great for teenagers, men, boys and girls, because it's not just about women. And then the second part, I would say, after this part, it's about periods in history, about all the culture around it, the bad things about it as well, is more for everybody. Okay, so if you're a grown-up, maybe the first part is interesting because there are some biological facts that are always nice to know, but the second part is more about culture, and that's a bit more interesting for people over maybe 20. So what I love about this book is for teenagers, it shows them that c'est normal, everything is okay about period, everybody, well, half the population of the world is concerned by it, and the other is concerned by it as well, and that's, it's okay, and it's better to know what's going on than being ignorant about it. So that's why she goes into details about everyday life about it, and that makes it a fantastic book. And I read it, so, and I'm not going to read it again right now, so I'm happy, very very happy to give it to a friend who has a teenage daughter and who started to think about this topic. So a fantastic book for everybody, and for teenagers it gives lots of things about biology, so that's why it's highly recommended. I know that teachers buy it for their classrooms, so the content in terms of science is good as well. The fourth one is the one I want to explore the most, and I have to say it was a bit of a surprise. It's called Le Guide des Métiers pour les petites filles qui ne veulent pas finir princesse. So it's jobs for little girls who don't want to end up princesses. It's by Catherine Dufour. And as you can see from the post-it here, it's really... I'm not a big fan of books that are made of lists, usually, because I tend to like bigger books, so where you have a whole story to get into. So I thought, okay, it was recommended by someone working in a bookshop, we say une librairie in France, and she said, oh, you're doing this episode on feminism, you should read that. Oh, I said, okay, I'm going to give it a try, and actually it's really good. So I put some post-its, yeah, because it presents jobs for anyone. And it presents women who did this job in the past and in the present. So it shows you how the job evolved as well. It's all in French, written by a Francophone person. And it's funny because some of those who are quoted here in the book are people I'm talking about in this episode. So for example, Virginie Despentes, who we're going to talk about later. We have one of our heroines from my partner and I. Was called Géraldine as well. She's a base jumper, and we're huge fans of hers. Alexandra David-Nel, I'm going to talk about her later. And then in other pages, it's all about awesome ideas of jobs and also women to look more into. And what's super interesting at the end of the book as well is that she tells us everything she hasn't talked about in the book that you can go and research, especially on the last page. There are lots of women that we call résistantes, and you have lots of names that you can go and look into. Especially, it's funny because for me the names that resonated the most are the people whose name I know, but I didn't know who they were. So for example, Germaine Tillion, Marie-Madeleine Fourcade, Lucie Aubrac as well. I knew they were from La Résistance, but I didn't know anything about them. So it gave me ideas on more resources in French to look into. So, Le Guide des Métiers pour les Petites Filles qui ne veulent pas devenir princesse. It's a wonderful book itself. And also the French is most spoken French, so you can really get into it easily, and it's very, very short. So for example, Philosophe has around 8 pages, and it's 4 pages from a job in the past and 4 pages on a job that's happening now. So wonderful book, no matter what gender or age you are. Le Guide des Métiers pour les petites filles qui ne veulent pas devenir princesse. And it's around €6.60. And if you don't know that, the price of books is fixed in France. So if it's usually written on the back and it's going to be sold at this price everywhere. So you don't have to look for a discount. It will always be the same price. King Kong Theory by Virginie Despentes is the fifth book. Honestly, I knew Virginie Despentes, but I wasn't very attracted by her work until now. And I'm a bit ashamed of saying that because I've been reading about feminism for a long time. And my brother was pushing me into reading it because he told me all his friends had read it and it's great. And then I told my friend about this episode today, and she told me, you have to read it, you have to recommend it. And I was like, I don't know about this writer, she's been very controversial, there are lots of things in the media, you know, bad about her. And then I said, okay, I'm going to read it, and I read it, and I loved it. So my bad, I was influenced in a bad way, and I have to admit it. So starting next week, I will read everything she's done because I love this book. King Kong Theory is about feminism and feminism in France as well. So it's a fantastic book. I would say it for everyone, but she's very, very straightforward. So there's something that might shock you. Most of it didn't shock me and I loved it, really. And it's short. This one is very short. It's un essai, as we say in France. So it's not a novel or anything. She wrote novels. This one is an essay about what it is to be a woman and lots of things about France itself. And at the end, again, just like for Le Guide des Métiers or Les Culottés, it pushes you to look into more things. She has une bibliographie and you have lots of ideas on what to read. I haven't talked about Simone de Beauvoir today. I won't because I could talk about it for hours. But you have lots of other feminism heroes and books to read and to go into from all over the world. So it was my best discovery, I would say, preparing this episode. King Kong Theory by Virginie Despentes, a fantastic book. It's been translated in, I think, maybe 20 languages. So if you don't feel like reading the French version because it's a bit difficult, read it in your own language. It's great and we can talk about it if you want. The sixth book, if I wasn't going to talk about Simone de Beauvoir, I had to talk about her. It's very, very different, but it's still one of my personal heroes. Alexandra David-Nel, I've talked about her earlier. She's a hero, she's an explorer, she's a society changer, everything. So this lady, she was from Belgium and she traveled to Eastern Asia alone at the beginning of the 19th century. And she talks about it in her first book, Voyage d'une Parisienne à Lhasa, which is the easiest to read. The other ones are more philosophical, so you can go and read them. But if you want to just start, you can read this one. I'm sure it's been translated in English as well, or Brazilian, or Spanish, depending on your language. So if you don't feel like reading it in French, you can read it in another language. I loved it, and she's one of my father's hero as well, so he pushed me into reading it, and as a stupid teenager, I always said, no, it's too boring, and then I started, and it's awesome. So this one is not about feminism itself, it's about a woman who did something that even men couldn't do. So she's mentioned in lots of other books that I talked about, and she's a fantastic person. Alexandra David-Nel, Voyage d'une Parisienne à Lhasa. Great, great book. That's it for today. I didn't put too many French words in this episode, I'm sorry, but I really wanted to show you these books, not only for La Journée Internationale du Droit des Femmes, but also because of resources that are outside of just the Learn French topic, that you can read in your own language and that can influence your children and your grandchildren and even yourself. And they're huge entertainment as well. So even if you don't care about French at all, you can enjoy them in your own language. They're highly, highly recommended. I wish you a great day, a great week, and I hope to see you next time. Salut!